All right, YouTube, today we're going to play some lands. This is the exact list from the SCG that beat us in the quarterfinals. Don't really know a lot of decks, so I'm not going to spend a lot of time talking about it. I've played 3 leagues, so this is likely going to be a little rough. So take it easy on me. But I do like it. It's fun. It's a different kind of Magic. So we're going to jump in and play one here. I went 3-2 in my last league, which was nice. I think I could have won this match, but my internet crapped out, so I couldn't finish it. But let's give this a whirl and play some lands. I've always liked this deck. I think I liked it because it usually just ranches all the decks that I like to play. Just get down. Okay, so we're on the draw. So we got a Manabond hand. Gonna keep this, put a million lands in play. Hopefully they don't kill this, take care of this Manabond. And then we're gonna ditch our Loam, and it's just absolute perfection. And we'll trigger the Manabond. Yes. Put a million lands in play, ditch this, and we're in good shape. Okay, so we're going to port this land on their upkeep. Then we're gonna fetch and then start loaming. And hopefully find a way to kill this 20. That's not good. Am I gonna get show and tell here? Not going to. This is tough. Such a quick start for us, but it's probably not going to be enough. Unless we loan something sweet back here. So let's get this Taiga out of the deck. We will dredge Loam. All right, we did not hit anything sweet. So we still will cast the Loam, get these back, play a land, move to our end step, then we'll just port them. It's the best we can do. So upkeep, port a land. Nothing from them yet is good. I don't think I've got 2 more lands I can fetch with this. I guess I shouldn't even fetch this thing, right? Isn't this better to have my deck so that I can mill over and draw cards? I'm going to do it because just in case we get in some weird situation where we start having to thaw this. Okay, so we hit Karakas, which is probably okay if they are a, which is probably okay if they're like a show and tell deck, which I think they are. They're either show and tell or storm. Then we'll probably just play this, port them, then start thawing our dark depths. So I can make them, I could port this right now and make them fetch and potentially mess up their brainstorm. I think I'm gonna do that. Because if they just let this go, then we do get to waste it. Oh, I have 6. Turn off auto yields. I guess I do get to port this. I mean, they're just gonna do this now anyways. It was probably, I have 6, but it was probably right to port this in response to that. Put a lands into play. I guess I could have ported this thing here because they obviously wanted a card. They didn't go in there. Man, they are digging. It's going to sneak attack, it looks like. I'm just going to wasteland the Scalding Tarn. Okay. That worked. Okay, so we hit Mox Diamond, Punishing Fire, Wasteland. So we didn't hit anything really good. We're gonna leave that thing in there. Oh, I forgot to thaw out the Dark Depths. So at least I get to start getting Punishing Fire back. We can get the slow burn from many different angles here. I cannot believe I'm not dead. Ooh, I tapped my Karakas. That wasn't good. Not going to get punished. I should have ported. I'm all over the place. So. Let's go like this. Need like a Thespian stage. We did hit a Ghost Quarter. And then another Grove. So let's keep this thing untapped. Probably can tap one of our. I guess we'll just. Should tap the one of the Taigas because this actually has an ability. So now we'll pass, put all of our lands into play, and then we'll just port. And then draw step, we'll probably get rid of this. Intuition, okay. Search your library for three cards. Hard to choose one of them. The card in your graveyard for the rest of your shuffle your library. So this is probably what kills me. Show and tell, yeah. Yes. Okay, so upkeep. Tap target land. Tap another target land. Inside of your draw step. Ghost Quarter you. This kind of feels like the best I can do. Because they likely have enough lands to show and tell here anyways. Then they show and tell Omniscience probably. And that's how they get me. Omniscience, okay. Cunning Wish. I think this kills me, right? Because they were like Fire Mind's Foresight. Then it's a combo. Or Intuition. So then they go get copies of whatever else they want. I'm pretty sure this is how they do it. Not exactly sure, though. Alright. So now they're just going to find their Emrakul. Sneak attack, okay. Brainstorm. I guess there's no need to bounce this thing. Just doing this because we can. It's probably not really any point. I guess it shuts off them being able to sneak attack. Now we bounce, thaw this. I don't have any idea what's going on over there for my opponent. Jeez. They must be just bricking really hard here. Okay, so there's our Emrakul. We bounce, they recast, so they take it in turns. Okay. Sad. But that's how it's supposed to go, right? We're supposed to lose to these kind of decks. Even after sideboard, I think. But we do have some good cards. We have 4 good cards. Probably 7 good cards to bring in. So we're going to bring these in. These all seem pretty great. Punishing Fires don't seem great. Molten Vortex doesn't seem great. Manabond's worse. Bojuka Bog doesn't seem that good. Tabernacle doesn't seem great. Or Glacial Chasm. I wonder if I need the Light from the Loam, or is that... Like, do I want Krosan Grips, or has by the time they've cast whatever it is, it's too late? They could have Blood Moon also, so I probably want Krosan Grips. Probably just, like, shave, because they're probably not going to extract this. Crop Rotation is probably decent. We want Exploration. I wonder how many lands I can cut. Like, Wasteland doesn't seem that great here. We'll try cutting 2 Wastelands. It's only, that puts us at 31 lands, which I don't know. I don't know if that's enough or not. We just need to get a lock piece going here. I'm gonna put my slippers on. I'll be right back. Yep, gonna play some Legacy C today. I might play Modern later, but I'm gonna start with lands. So this hand's pretty good. Well, I can gamble for like... What am I doing with this hand? This hand's actually not that great. Besides the fact that I can Chalice on one next turn. And like hopefully that gets me there. I have 2 Krosan Grips. I think I'm going to mulligan. Yeah, I think I'm going to mull. This hand does not really do anything besides potentially make a quick 20-20. If I play Modern after this, I'm going to play Death Shadow. But I don't know if that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to keep this hand because it has an Exploration. And if we have like a Thespian stage or a Crop Rotation or like a Sphere effect on top, then... We can jam it early. You are on Grixis Shadow, or yeah, I'm playing Grixis Shadow. If that's what you're asking. Okay. I thought it was tanking. I don't know, like, their hand's probably close, but one of those that, like, loses to a lock piece. I think I'm going to keep this because we can get a quick 20-20. If we hit, like, 8 draws, we've got 8 draws that are really good. Having 3 of these is obviously not good, but... Like, this is, like, not having access to a lock piece, but having a potential at a fast guy is probably decent. I'm not sure, though. Preordain, okay. Something good. That wasn't good. Oh, so this is in the graveyard. Does this get around Blood Moon? I guess now if they Blood Moon me, I guess, no, we did see red. Oh, I could have played another land. Gosh. I'm so used to playing one land at a time. Lotus Petal, okay. It's go time. Okay, that's actually not that bad, because we have the forest. The sphere is pretty good, too. Keep this one. Oh, that was stupid. I shouldn't have tapped my land there. Or I shouldn't have tapped my blue land. Now we just wait. We've got three Krosan Grips. Krosan Grips does just make it 2020 now because of the new rule, which is sweet. Just pass. Gonna show and tell me, dude? Nope. Just pondering. What does this do? It probably doesn't do anything. Let me pull up my deck list here. It probably doesn't do anything with this Blood Moon play. Nope. Doesn't do anything with the Moon in play. Because it puts it in the play, right? It doesn't. Crop rotation. Search I put the card on the battlefield. It's not like I could go get the Tranquil Thicket and have it in my hand. Ooh, okay. So now we're going to EOT, blow this Moon up, and look to kill him. Choose an instant from outside of the game. Intuition. Okay. I think that's going to be too slow. Because that costs four. Yeah, I said like a hate card for this 2020. That's right. 1, 2, 3, 4. And like we're just going to grip this Moon and get him. I guess they could, like, search for a repeal. Like, three repeals. And then that would get me. I don't know. They must have some card to deal with this. Like, Echoing Truth. Brainstorm. Okay. We're looking for a Stifle. I guess I just did give them six mana. So they can intuition into something. But we can just do it again next turn with the crop rotation if this doesn't work. All right, sweet. We made 2020. I think we're just going to keep with it. Same thing on the draw. I don't think this is really a player draw matchup. Yeah, I've wanted to play this deck for a while, but just haven't had the resources to do it, so I'm kind of excited to try this. Okay, so this is a turn one Chalice, turn two Sphere. So we're going to hope that's fast enough. I guess we play what? We play Sphere first. Sphere's probably better than Chalice on one. Then we play Chalice after. At least I think. I think the sphere is better, so he doesn't just jam on me. Ancient Tomb. Maybe Chalice in next turn. I can't cast any spells, but like, whatever. Yeah, I can't cast any spells, but I think we're just going to try to figure that out. Yeah, we can't cast half of our hand, but I think that's probably better than giving him time. Then next turn, we just start porting him to slow him down. And then hopefully we find something. I don't really know what that is, but City of Traders. Okay, so we're going to port that for sure. Okay, Thespian Stage isn't bad. It should let me copy my port next turn. So I can start porting two lands. Cunning Wish, okay. So even if they go to get two Show and Tells, it's still kind of slow. They took Intuition, okay. So we're gonna Intuition now. Ruh-roh. You get a Show and Tell. So they have Show and Tell in their hand. We kind of just hope they don't have another mana source. They're going to need running mana sources in order to get me here. Okay. Taiga's Dece as well. What does the Taiga do? Tiger doesn't do anything because I can't really cast either of these. So, again, we're just going to port them, and then we're going to copy our port. And then port another one of their lands next turn. We're just going to try to lock them out here. Because now they need two lands at least to cast their Show and Tell. I'd like to find a Life from the Loam, just start churning through my deck. I don't know when I'm going to have the time to cast it, but... Okay, so Ancient Tomb lets them play Show and Tell. Okay, so we're going to put in the Maze. They play Omniscience. So, does it matter? Does copying this even matter now? What do I want to copy with this thing? Probably nothing. I should copy something. Probably should just copy Maze of Ith in case they get two big guys in play. We drew a Maze of Ith. So this is for free plus one, right? Okay, so there's Sneak Attack. Now I kind of want to copy, because we drew the Maze, I'm going to copy a port. So... Yeah, I don't even think I... Do I even start loaming? If I was going to loam, I shouldn't have played that land. Because then I could, like, loam plus one of them. I think I'm going to loam next turn. Because I can then play a land and still have two port activations. Well, hang on. Well, no, I can't port. I can't save the mana from the Ancient Tomb, so never mind. Let's tap this, and then tap this. Then go for it. All right, you've got a Gristlebrand. Draw a million cards. Blood Moon. That's bad. Okay. So now I don't even know what I'm going to hit. Okay, I got it. You got it, opponent. GG's. Oh. My stream is tweaking out there for a second. I feel like we put up a pretty good fight there. I don't know. Like, for how poor this is supposed to be. Like, you know, we took a game. We were in it. We were fighting a good fight. I'm gonna grab some more water. I'll be right back. Where are my computer glasses? I don't see where I put my computer glasses. All right, we'd like to play first. I got a mulligan in this hand. This hand doesn't do anything. This hand doesn't really do a lot either. Something I don't know is when I have these hands, what do I gamble for? No, that's probably okay. I'd probably gamble for something like Tabernacle if they're a creature deck. Maybe Loam. My opponent kept seven. So what is this? Search your library for a card. Put that card in your hand. I guess because I have two of those, I could have just in the dark gambled for... Okay. So let's play around Days, even though we can't do it this turn. So we're going to get Tabernacle with this one. And then I think I'm going to gamble next turn after I get rid of my Tabernacle. So I don't want to discard it, and then I don't want to... I don't want to discard my Tabernacle, and I don't want to play into Days. You're going to waste me? Okay. All right, so we are going to get one of these bad boys. So now I can actually go like this. So we're going to gamble first. Because if they Daze it, we play Tabernacle, we get rid of both of their Delvers. No. Play Tabernacle and pass. And now we get both of them. Why are there four triggers? Oh, at the beginning of 1K. Okay. It's the Delver trigger and the Destroy trigger. Alright, so you waste this. It did its damage, though. So now if we find a Loam, we're in good shape. But we do have to find one. All right, we'll take that too. So let's copy the Wasteland. They stifle me, then whatever. Just gonna get this Taiga. Copy the Wasteland. And then waste them. In their upkeep. So if they stifle, that we can at least burn their mana. Yeah, so they have a stifle. Okay, so they have a Wasteland, so they're probably going to waste our waste. Yep. Now we pass. We're just looking for a Loam or a Gamble. I'm going to play a Tarmogoyf. That's going to be kind of an issue here. Or a Goose. Yeah, it's a big boy. All right, we got a Loam. Tabernacle, Wasteland. Grove. This is, he's probably going to force this or daze this. At least I think he's got to. All right, so let's play this. Let's play this. Waste the green because we just don't. We're just going to like work him off of his. This, work him off the Tarmogoyfs. Dredge Loam. So Wasteland, Thespian Stage, Dark Depths this time. Okay, so let's play Thespian Stage. And then I'm just going to play this Mox Diamond, dish this Dark Depths. And then I should be pretty set up to give him to go for the kill next turn. I think we're going to be good here. We are getting smacked, so we just have to make sure not to get bolted out of the game, but we're pretty close to just setting up our combo also. So Loam this back. Cast Loam. Let's get back. Dark Depths, Wasteland, Bojuka Bog. Okay, they just scoop it up. All right. I almost don't even want to change anything. I feel like my deck's made to beat this deck. Like, I could bring in these spheres and nonsense, but I think I just kind of want to, like, keep it as is. Like, this choke's probably okay, but it's kind of slow. Like, all my cards seem kind of decent. Maybe the Molten Vortex isn't that great. The game's not going to go long enough to where tracker matters. Like, the only cards I want to bring in are tracker. And if I was going to do that, I think I would go like this. But I don't want to get got by a Delver on one, so let's try this. Do I want to board out any of my lands? Probably Karakas isn't great. You like Chalice? Chalice makes me play the Ancient Tomb. And, like, Chalice also messes up my game plan a lot. That's just what I've noticed. So I don't know how good it is. I probably could, like, shave a Loam, shave a Tracker, maybe cut my Trackers and go like this. Maybe I got some other poor lands. Let me see. Glacial Chasm's good. All my Destroy lands are good. Port's good. I just don't know if you're supposed to bring this card in outside of anything but combo decks. Because it also messes with these cards. Like your gambles and your crop rotations, which can be kind of your engine. You could play something weird like a Sulfuric Vortex too. So let's try this. Yeah, I could cut some gambles. I kind of don't want to get got by like a Sulfuric Vortex. Like, is that crazy? That's probably crazy. Let's go like this. I've only got two of these. Maybe I should have more of these. Maybe I should just have, like more of this effect. Because we know they're going to bring in Surgical. So maybe go with something like this. I have no idea. We're going to try this. I feel like if we're going to bring the chalices in, we should bring the spheres in as well. Like, not doing both of them kind of seems like we're just, we don't have the heart. You know what I mean? Like, we want to just stick our toes in, but not go everywhere. Not go all the way in. Okay, so we got a turn one sphere, which I'm in the market for. All right, I'm going to give him the opportunity to daze one of these. Okay, let's ditch our Dark Depths. How do I get this sphere to resolve? Cast crop rotation, he counters it. Play port, play sphere, probably. No, we've already played a land, so I'd have to play another one of these and ditch, like, ditch probably this Taiga. What am I getting this? If this resolves, I'll get Wasteland. No, I should have done this. I should have played the Taiga because the forest can't get wasted. That was a mistake. Wow. Okay, so let's go get... I guess we just go get Wasteland. Waste our opponent's. Play another one of these, ditching the Taiga, and then cast Sphere Resistance. Wow, that all worked. So let's just hope this Delver never flips, which it doesn't look like it's going to. Wow, they kept one land. Oh, they have a land, okay. And we hit a Loam, holy shit. These are some decent draws, ladies and gentlemen. Get to play land. Right? All right, play the Rishadan Port. I must have played the port. Okay. Yeah, because we crop rotation on one for a Wasteland. So we flipped a Bolt. Which is a good one. Okay, so we hit a Grove. So I guess I should just waste this. He's going to waste this port back. We'll go like this, and then we'll just Loam. Loam back Grove, Wasteland Port. So now it's just like a race against this Delver. Okay, now they can flip it. All right, so we hit a maze, which is good. So let's play our land. We don't want to get it wasted because we want to start to like set up shop here. We might start taking draw steps after we get this Maze of Ith in play, because I would like to hit something to let us play a bunch of land. So I think we're just going to take draw steps here. What do you got, sir? You got another Delver to play? Well, whatever it is, it costs 2 mana. Oh, they just messed this up. Now they're going to get this thing wasted. That sucks. Again, we're just going to take a draw step. Let's just waste this. So that means they probably have something like a Nimble Mongoose in their hand. And I think I'm just going to like draw for the rest of the game pretty much. I just want to hit. I want to hit like. I mean, I could Life from the Loam looking for Tabernacle to probably like seal this up. But I would like to just hit cards to, just be able to draw something that lets me play multiple lands would be sweet. All right, Punishing Fire is also sweet. So let's play this. 5 p.m. stream. Yeah, work was slow. So I got out. We actually lost power on our street. So I was just like, yeah, I'm leaving. If we can't do anything. Now we just start the long grind. The old 2020 the hard way. My opponent finds a Nimble Mongoose. I guess that's sort of like a way we lose. Tanner, yeah, I hope he shows up. Yeah, the goose could be a problem. So we're probably going to, yeah, here comes a goose. No bueno. That sucker is loose. So now do I start loaming? I probably have to loam because I've got to find a way to just like deal with this. So we have Port, Sphere, Wasteland. No, I can't do this because I can't actually cast my loam. Or I can't actually cast anything. So let's go like this. Let's waste them. All right, let's ditch Dark Depths, Ancient Tomb. We have a 4-turn clock. We can play another one now. I think we're looking for Tabernacle because they can stifle my trigger. Misty Rainforest, Ancient Tomb. So we didn't find anything. So let's... We can get back the Tranquil Thicket to give us more draws. Another Wasteland. Yeah, Bojuka Bog would be sweet. That's my opponent's last. No, they have one more green land. Unless they stifle this, which they could. They stifle this, though. They're making themselves a little more open to the 2020. Yeah, Schultz Chew, we're playing some lands. We are playing lands today. Stitch this. We're in a little bit of a tough spot. We're in like a little bit of a pickle. Wasteland. Okay, so now they have a bolt, so we're dead. Let's make sure. Yeah, we're dead. All right, game three. Going to Orlando, but not playing the GP. What a punt, dude! You seem like a Bant Nexus of Fate kind of guy. So how do I board here, Schultz Cube? Do we bring in like? Do we just go ham? I think on the play we go ham with these. Why didn't you try to Punishing Fire at the Delver? Because I had the Maze of Ith, and I think I was digging for a way to deal with the Mongoose, and I couldn't, like, I didn't have enough mana, right? I bought out Loams because I thought they would bring in, like, Surgicals and Graveyard Hate. At least everybody's been bringing in Graveyard Hate against me. So I don't know if that was right or not to do. Cut Spheres, add back Loams, and choke. Okay. And that's 60. You like adding trackers too? Yeah, thanks, Odemaria. I hit submit though, so I don't think we're going to go. I hit submit, so I don't think we're going to get there. All right, I would like to play first. Okay, so this hand's a really fast 2020 with like a way to kill a Delver. So I think this hand's good. Yeah, this is like a, like they kind of have to force this. I guess they don't have to, but like on, like they might think they do. Yeah, so that's forcible. They got rid of the Daze. Thanks, Odemaria. His hand's patchily. Yeah, turn two. So we're definitely going to murk a Delver if he plays one here. He plays a Goose. The Goose is loose. I think I cycle this. Okay. We're just going to do this now before he untaps. We're just going to get Forest. Play fetch into stage. Oh, of staging a Forest. That makes sense. All right, so we're looking for a Tabernacle here. Dark Depths. So you're saying, Schultz, we just hold here, we copy our Forest, and then next turn we just bang, go for it. Hopefully he plays a Tarmogoyf or something like that. Casually top decks, no, Loam. I think this is what we do, right? We just copy our Forest, which like looks decent, and then we just like go for it. Hit a Wasteland. No bueno. That's okay. We're still just going to copy the Forest. I could also copy his Wasteland. Or scroll all objects, no, don't. So I'll probably just copy his Wasteland now. Like, two can play at this game. Yeah, if you waste here, we get it back. Okay. So now play a land. Let's not get dazed. There's another Taiga in the deck, so I can still cycle this. Spell appears. Okay. They might get under me here. If they wanted to live. Okay, that makes sense. That makes sense. Playing right into it. So this, 1, 2, 3, 4. So they've almost got threshold. They have 5 cards. 6 cards. These gooses get loose this turn. I'm gonna be a little nervous. I probably should have fetched in response to that. No, that makes sense, Archmage. Don't play a fetch land. Damn it. The goose is loose. That's odd. They must have just misclicked. Surgicaling, what are you targeting? You're targeting my Verdant Catacombs. Why would you target my Verdant Catacombs? That seems nuts. Especially when I have a Thespian stage in the graveyard? He just went LOL sure in chat, so I don't know. Maybe he like misclicked. I don't know. So we get cracked here for 6. Dredge Loam. Okay, so there's Bog. So that Bog buys us time. So Bog, Thespian Stage, Tranquil Thicket. Tranquil Thicket also protects us from Surgical, which makes sense for them to have another one. So now we just hold this Tranquil Thicket to just play around a Surgical from them. We take 2, then we play Thespian Stage. I think we're okay. We gotta find like a crop rotation or something like that. Wasteland. I think I cycle this to just draw a card. I guess it doesn't really matter. I'm going to draw cards either way. I guess we'll just do the Loam, and we'll draw for our turn. Okay, so we hit a bunch of Loams. I guess we dredge. Okay, so we hit Dark Depths. I don't really know what to do here. I think I cycle this and look to draw, just draw a card, and then I play this Thespian Stage and hold up and like be able to copy this. Because if I hit like an exploration or something like that, I can actually start like doing stuff now. And if this doesn't work, I'll just start loaming. Okay, so exploration's huge. Okay, so now we just loam back Thespian Sage, Tranquil Thicket. No, I need to play a land. Casually calling it. Everyone's good at something. Here, here, here. I'll target this one. Whatever. Confirmed Legacy Genius. I guess it might have been better to play the Thicket there. So I guess now I can 20/20 them, right? Because I play Dark Depths. I pass on their end step. I target their Wasteland. And then if they do anything after that, I make a 20/20. And then, like, I just untap and do it. And it's just blockers. Leaves us in trouble against Lightning Bolt. But I think that's what we're going to do here. Because, like, copy Wasteland, then copy Dark Depths, I think is how we're going to do this. Dude, hitting that exploration was big game. Could also main phase your combo next turn. They play, then play two depths and do it again on your turn when they waste it. That makes sense. So let's loam. Okay, we hit just Grove, so that doesn't matter. So if I play two depths and then I just, if he's got Stifle plus Wasteland and this flips, then I'm in trouble. But then I've got to make sure to loan back Punishing Fire next turn. So let's. I think I like copying it. They waste it. We can't beat Bolt. Submerge also gets us two. Well, that's not how that works, buddy. Joke's on you. Oh, no, it isn't. I thought that's how that worked. Okay, so now we just make this one. And we hope this last card's not a stifle. It's not. Okay. So we lose to Bolt. This Delver flips. We still just lose to Bolt. So Delver flips, which gives him a turn. No, I guess we can just get back. We can just Punishing Fire this, and we got him. So let's loam. Okay, so we got Wasteland, Glacial Chasm. So that's pretty good. So let's just cast this Punishing Fire. See what happens. That makes sense. Do we get him? Do you got it? Yeah, we can do a chasm lock, right? Where we just copy it every turn. Come on. Did we get there? Did we get there, boys? Come on. Come on. Let me fly in with my Merit Liege. Come on. Come on. What are you tanking about? Thinking about how tilted they are. I'm just going to write test in the chat. I'm going to go fill my water up and run to the bathroom too. Be right back. See, now they're just going to, like, time me out. So I guess we get to, like, at least report them. Whatever. Hang on, wait. When did I do this? It's been 3 minutes. Yeah, I mean, if they don't make report player conduct, report player. Report conduct violations here. My opponent's a child. Is this Moto or is this? All right, we can go like this. Also, time me out while BLB. Wow, dead on board. Oh, this is great. Yeah, we got lucky. We hit a couple times really lucky. Magic Online, no. How do you know? Yeah, this just sucks because, like, it just takes away from, like, all of our. That's frustrating. All right, let's just move over here for now. We'll put the deck list, put the deck up here. I don't understand why this is so difficult for me to report this. Like, this website here, I don't even know. Like, report an issue, report conduct. No. So this article is not helpful. I don't want to go to Arena. What a joke this is. My opponent's just being a jerk. And then I can't even report this because, like, how weird this is. We could use this time to drive Zendikar. We could. They scooped it up. Nice. It's about damn time. I should have put in my pizza for dinner tonight. That's what I should have done. I would like to play first. This hand's a mulligan because I can't produce green mana. This hand is a keep. It doesn't matter what this is. I think I don't want this. Though, I guess I could just go bing. No, I don't think we want this. I don't really know the sequencing here. Like, I'm sure there's a right way to do this. Dude, I love pizza. Yeah, I'm sure there's a right way to sequence that. I'm just not exactly... I just don't exactly know how to do it. I was sad to see only one land in the Pro Tour. The deck made like 7k. Yeah, I would agree. So what do I want to gamble for? What would be sweet? I don't know. I'm just going to get another Taiga. I guess I could have gotten played Mox Diamond, ditched this. Yeah, that's what I should have done. Oh, I should. This is all dumb because I gambled here, and now my gamble's worse. Missed block constructed ones. Yeah. So I want to know if there's a way that I can like overload my opponent's mana here. Because, like, they're probably some blue-white control deck. And maybe I have to set up, like, a Ghost Quarter lock or something like that. Maybe they're a control deck. Maybe they're a fair deck. Maybe I just gamble for, like, Ghost Quarter. Yeah, I think that's the plan. It's either that or Port, I think. It was a turn two brainstorm. So this is like an honest brainstorm. Plays planes. Okay. EE for one. Okay. I'm going to fetch before I mill over this and this land's dead. So now I almost think that I should just go get, like, just start ghost quartering them out of this game. So we hit Dark Depth, Sheltered Thicket. So let's gamble. Oh, shoot, because now if I, no, that was so bad. Because now if I ditch Loam, that's so bad. Oh, no. Oh no, this is bad. Oh, this is potentially bad. We're still going to do it. Yeah. Just get a second loan. We did not. So now I'm just going to start, like, I guess just ghost quartering him out of the game. That's going to be slow, though, without another exploration. So main deck EEs is not nice from our opponent. I think I'm just going to loan ghost quarter until they... All right, so here we go. Probably should have hit the planes. They probably have less planes in their deck. So now this is either Wasteland or they don't get to draw a card here. Yeah, I should have definitely hit the white one. So now they don't know what this is, so this is going to be worse. They mean ponder and they hit volcanic. Yeah, so that's the game plan. We're going to hit two white sources next turn. If they don't have a land here, then we get to hit more. I guess we don't get to hit more. But we get to go like ghost quarter, loam back, ghost quarter. Okay, yeah, so now they blow this up. They're not going to blow this up? No way. Well, they must have a counterspell for this loam. All right, port, ghost quarter. I guess sheltered thicket. They could do that as well. And if they do that, I'm just going to play probably port. They're going to force this. Whoa. All right. Now we're just going to blow this planes up. That makes sense. All right, draw step. So now we just get back. Maze. Then we get back port. So we're going to play a Snapcaster Mage probably. So next time we get back port. Port, Ghost Counter, Thespian Stage. Hopefully I don't just go land Jace. That would be bad. Don't play a Jace. That's worse. That is worse than a Jace. Karakas, this isn't legendary. No! Thespian Stage. Rishadan Port. Ghost Quarter or Dark Depths? Probably just get Ghost Quarter. That's already pretty redundant. So I guess I'm just going to go get... Unclick this mission and pour, get Ghost Quarter Dark Depths. Now I'm in trouble. I think we're dead. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I think we are super, super dead here. I could find, like, I don't know. I could find, I guess, whatever the card is. Tabernacle? saying Chasm gets me out of this. It kind of does, right? Isn't it too slow? I guess they can't, like, bolt me out of the game. Like, I just play it. Yeah, we're good. We're good here. I'm taking a million damage here. I guess we'll wait one more turn. I might hit Tabernacle. But even Tabernacle, I'm taking 7. They know their top card, too, from the Brainstorm, which is sick. We just pay it and play. But aren't we, like, stone raiding ourselves while we do that? Does that, like, get me anywhere? Like, is that playing? Is that just, like, not to lose or playing to win? Which, like, we might not even be in a position to play this game to win, which if that's, you know, if that's where we're at, then, like, you know, what's the point? All right, so let's get back this. Loam. All right, so we have Punishing Fire, but that's just too little too late. 1, 2, 3, 4, 3. Yeah, we're good. We're good. Yeah, that's what I was meaning. Like, it's playing, like, I just don't know if playing to Chasm is a way to win the game, you know? So, Schultz, against this deck, do we bring in the Spheres and the Chalices? I think we want Trackers, Chokes. I'm going to assume that they have, like, Back to Basics or something. So do we want all these cards? Like, if I want all of these, I have no idea. Like, so Molten Vortex goes. Cut Gamble. Add everything else. Okay. So we probably cut Punishing Fires, too? Molten Vortex, I'm assuming, goes. I'm going to start picking out lands here. I'm going to assume this isn't great. This Maze of Ith probably aren't great. The Tabernacle is probably medium. Manabond, yeah. You just always, don't you always board out Manabond whenever you board anything else in that's any good? I don't know how many lands we can board down to. Yeah. This is what my gut tells me. I don't know if this makes sense or not to anybody else that's watching, but I think we're going to try this. This is what my gut tells me. I would like to play first. Yeah. This hand's pretty fast. I think we just go like, because this is like a really quick Merit Lage with Steel Resistance. Bog maybe. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, I don't know. I don't play this deck too often. I think this hand's very good, though. So we're going to go, like, Mox Diamond, ditch our Windswept Heath. Then next turn... Oh, they're going to force this? Okay. They force a pitch into Jace. I think we take that. So now we're kind of like all we're out of gas. That forest was pretty solid. Oh, there's the bog. So now do I just ditch the tomb and go start working on getting them? That doesn't seem right to do. We're going to do this because if they do anything silly, we can just crop rotation and get them. They only got one land. Okay. So I don't really know how to play this song and dance here. Cancel. Play this. Like, I don't know if I'm supposed to, like, jam, but I can't really put it back together. If I could put it back together, I would think about it. So now they can kill my Mox Diamond, I guess. Which seems slightly small ball. If I draw another piece. My opponent says question mark. I didn't want to go for it, dude. I just want to thaw out. Three. I'm trying to ditch this. Wait one more turn on the bog. I have lines for you. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know the best way to do this. If I had a loam, we'd be good. Because like then I could just start just going for it every turn. We don't have a Sejuri step now. That doesn't really do anything. So I'm trying to think if there's anything I can do with this crop rotation. Maze, Glacial Chasm, Ghost Quarter. I kind of just want to hold it until I draw a way to recur things. I'm going to play this, though. Like right Schultz, the best thing to do here is just wait and don't do anything until we get a loan. Oh, hang on. It's catch 22. All right, so now they have two lands. But once I get a loan, we're good, right? I like to jam, but sometimes you have. But sometimes you have to jam. Okay. Well, that's probably a good way to start. Well, we kind of lose, right? Or at least we slow down because they can go like plow, untap, Jace. And I'm just going to bog to get rid of, because I can snap this Preordain back at some point. Or they're going to flash in a Snapcaster. No, they're not, because then the Snapcaster Mage doesn't untap. Whoa. Are we getting a Snapcaster Mage here? Oh, they had a disenchant. Okay. All right. I guess this actually gives them a window to play Jace, which is bad. Don't do it. Don't jam the Jace. We might have messed up, chat. Monastery Mentor. Okay. If only we had more mana, we could go like crop rotation, wasteland, make the dude. If he taps for either white source, you can crop rotation for port and then jam. But the problem is they get to untap, right? Right, doesn't he? He just gets to untap, and we're good, right? Not this turn. Oh, okay, yeah. That's a good draw. Let's get this out of here. Oh, you did it on his turn to bait him? I see what you're doing. Oh, he ditched a Jace. Okay. Yeah, you're right. So I should have waited on his turn to make it so you would tap mana to cast spells. No, that makes sense. That makes sense. They're surgically my punishing fire. Always yield. Always yield. Always yield. Yeah, let this happen. So I think we're getting very close to just jamming. You know, like we're behind here. I definitely should have waited to do it on their turn in order to get them to tap mana. Rotate for Grove. Yeah, see, that's I just didn't went over my head. We might have to rotate for Maze of Ith also, not to die here. So this is 4, 6. This is 10 damage. We boarded out our Tabernacle. Okay. Oh, no way. So now I have to respond with this on the stack. The problem is he's got another. I don't have quite enough to get him. So we just get Ghost Quarter. And then hope they don't have a second light source. No, I can't do that because I die. We can just Ghost Quarter, make the 2020 and block. Yeah, well, that's what we're going to do. All right, we're going to go for it. Show me your plow. All right, taking one more draw step. Yeah, they got it. GG's opponent. I think I probably could have played maybe I should have been more aggressive. Not exactly sure how that works out there. Let's win our last two. Go 3-2 in our league. It's not a good matchup. Okay. I should probably go start my pizza. All right, let me just finish prepping this. Good quick threat. Okay, that makes sense. I would like to play first. This hand does not seem good. Like, if we're playing a creature deck, it's very good, but I don't even keep that. Yeah. Put on top. Maybe. I don't think I want this. So what am I gambling for? Probably just gambling for Loam. I think. Oh no, I clicked through my turn. Oh man. Literally just checking out how my stream was going, and I just clicked right through the turn there. We don't need to be doing that against a deck with Preordain in it. put two cards on top. You think this guy still plays Storm? Well, if he plays Storm, should we just scoop and go to the next game? God, we lost to Storm in the top eight of this Open that we hit there with our teams. Like, we lost to Storm. That felt so bad. Like, ugh. Scalding Tarn. Am I dead? Not dead. Wonder why they fetch Underground Sea. I'm not going to show him I drew this because I can't do anything with the mana yet. It doesn't matter doing it this turn or next turn. And like punishing firing them out isn't going to work. Wow, they have no land. Oh, had to get C. Okay. I kind of don't want to show off this Mox Diamond yet. Like, I just want to port him. Because I'm not doing anything with the Diamond. Keep him tapped out, yeah. Watching my friend play Storm of the Team Open was so much fun. Like, he took such a long time. He took such a long time thinking about his mulligans, and then the game would be just over. And I still think we don't even play the Diamond. Just keep porting him. I just got like a link from some dude that wanted me to follow his YouTube channel. I was like, dude, I don't even know who you are. I don't even know who this guy is. So he chose not to shuffle, which probably isn't good. So I can loan back Wasteland, and then hit this island, which is probably my best line of play. Or just like... Because I can't, if I let them untap with two mana after keeping cards on Ponder, I think I'm going to die. So I think I'm just going to green, waste this, then untap. And just pass. Okay, so there's black mana. Ruh-roh. Dress. We got nothing. Dark Petition goes gets passed in flames. They discarded Pass in Flames. So they just get another ritual. Cast Pass in Flames. Yeah, we're good. We don't need to make him go through it. Yeah, I'm assuming we're dead. We're not going to make him go through it. Oh, we're getting beat up. All right, let's see. I think we want... All these come in, this comes in, and maybe these Krosan Grips come in. Not sure. Cards I don't want, definitely. I don't think I want these Punishing Fires. Manabond. But we don't want Glacial Chasm, Karakas, Maze of Ith. I guess I can keep the Tabernacle just in case they just in case they try to goblins me. But yeah, I probably don't want the grips. That seems like a little overzealous. Probably can bring. Oh, hang on, let me go put my. You can just cut all these gambles? Like, what do you think of this? Let me just, I'll be right back. I'm just gonna put my pizza in. Let me sideboard here and then I'll figure that out. I'm going to do a timer for this stupid thing. Alright, what time is it now? It is 5:53. Okay. So we'll board out one more of these, bring this in. Cut these. And then submit. All right, it's 5:53. Surface lighter movies. They have to play on a turn in advance due to spheres. That makes sense. All right, so this hand's not good enough. This hand is as good as we're going to get, I think. We don't want this. I'm not going to show him the port yet. You got me on one, bud? Uh-oh. Uh-oh, no. Oh, man, they hit my sphere. What a tilt. That's actually not a terrible draw because it lets me start loaming and I can port. Looks like my timer's working. Maybe if I tell you OP they can pet Philly, they will just concede. Maybe. Maybe that's the plan. Listen here, you can pet my dog. I choose not to shuffle, which can't be good. Do we need to take a draw step? What can I do with this loam? Hit like two wastelands? Okay. YOLO. We didn't hit anything. What a tilt. We'll leave the Sheltered Thicket because it's a good... good thing to loan or cycle. We're just gonna upkeep, hit the black source, and then die. Yeah, OP, you can hang out with my dog. Oh no. Oh no, don't kill me. Don't kill me. Come on, don't kill me. I could have played that Misty Rainforest, I believe. Would have had one more mana, which might matter. Or crop. Okay. I guess I should have thought about it, because I had, at that point, I had two spheres and two chalices left in my deck. Crop rotation doesn't really do anything besides get a wasteland, I guess, versus three looks at a land, a wasteland, basically. So I have more outs. Probably should have. So now do I draw this turn? Okay, that's got to be all right, right? Means we're not dying. I boarded the chasms out. I don't know if I'm supposed to do that or not. So now we just draw. What's going on? So we just keep cards in our, keep this in our hand and pass. Isn't tendrils not damaged though? Let me see. And then we're just going to F6, let my opponent do its thing. We're going to sacrifice. Prevent all damage it would dealt to you. So it doesn't do anything under. Like, it doesn't do anything with tendrils, right? Yeah. Oh, we're dying. All right, we're going to play out the last match. Wait, actually, they have a tutor, right? They ponder. Isn't that kind of dangerous? Ritual into tendrils. 11 times. They got it. They got it. All right, let's play the last match. We can't cash, but I'm having fun playing this deck. I am having fun. Where is the link that showed all of the modern deck lists from the Pro Tour? Because I would also like to try Magnus Lantos's Grixis Shadow deck that he played. Top 8 Stories, Magic Pro Tour. Silver Showcase Finals. Modern deck lists. Here we go. It's on Reddit. I just found it. Dude, I can't handle Reddit. I try to like navigate through Reddit and it just confuses me so much. It's like, what is going on? This deck's fun to play, I think. It's just different. I'm not sure I can play this at a real event because it's like, I just don't think I would win at all with it. Like, just because I don't know it well enough and it's not really my wheelhouse, but it is a nice little change up. I think I'm going to play Death Shadow at the SCG. So I am going to have to, like, get those cards here and probably play Death Shadow for a week or two in order to make sure I have that all set up. So I think that is the SCG the one in Baltimore? Is it? I think it's the one in Baltimore. I think – let me see. I would like to play first. All right, let's just – I don't know why my computer doesn't load a thing here. Yeah, this is we go with this. This is a turn to 2020. I don't play a lot of Legacy. When I get the chance to, though, I like playing Delver decks. I thought it was Legacy, but I might be wrong. Maybe there's a Legacy Classic. Because this is a big whatever it is, a big Legacy area. Nope, no legacy. Okay. Modern Open, Modern Standard Classic. Okay. What is going on? Like, why can't this thing? I'm trying to. I don't want to get to the where to play thing. I want to get. I click on this tweet. Like, check this out. Everybody, you want to see what pisses me off about Wizards of the Coast? Okay. Magic Pro Tour 25th Anniversary Modern Decklist. Right here. Click on this. And it just it brings me to like find where to play thing. I'm like, what is going on? This has nothing to do with what I want to do here. So now I think I'm just gonna like it's very likely that they have plow, but we can make up for that. So I think I'm just gonna jam so that we don't get wastelanded. It's very like unlikely they have Wasteland, but like we don't really care if they deal with this because we just rebuild. Check back in a minute or two. Yeah, but like okay, there it is. So where is Control F Death's Shadow? Harosayuta. Let's go down one more to Ben Jones. Yep, Ben Jones right there. It's a friend. All right, let's download this. Okay, so they plowed me. But now we just... go for it again. It doesn't really matter which lands I play. Because, like, the odds of them actually having, whatever it is, the odds of them actually having it are so low. Let me get this. Oh, shoot. All right, you got it there, buddy. Dashboard, deck editor. Let's just get the tapped one. Okay, so now we just go get... Wasteland Port. And now we kind of can just... Oh, I didn't click on the Windswept Heath on accident. Slusher Storm this. Okay. All right, we're just going to threaten to make it anyways. Whoa, I guess they fetched that. Okay, okay. And copy the ghost quarter. And then just get ready to try to like overload their mana. Get back Rishadan Port, get back Wasteland. I think as long as we have this loan, we can just, like, keep on keeping on, right? We just get Port, Wasteland, Windswept Heath. Like, eventually we're going to be able to set something up where we just, like, close them out of this game, I think. And my Thespian stage is so cleverly hidden. Yeah, like, we're just going to be able to set up shop and then just eventually, like overload them. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. And then we're going to make it 2020. Just get them. Are you thinking about forcing this? Also, the nice thing is that we're not going to get jaced anytime soon, I don't think. That's how I keep losing these. I keep just getting jaced out of the game. Dude, I was streaming last night. I don't know if anybody else was here that was there last night. But, like, I was having my normal, like, Sunday stream beers, like, kind of taking it easy. Only had, like, 30 or 40 viewers. Okay, so I got a Snapcaster. Only had about 30 or 40 viewers. But then, like, everybody just came in from Jeff's stream. And all of a sudden, I had 1,000 people in my watching me. And I was just like, oh, my God, I can't handle this shit. So now we just go ghost quarter, I think. We're just not going to pay for this. I guess I could have paid for that. Just paid 3, gotten it back. Yeah, that was stupid. That was very loose. Because I could have just paid 3, got it back, and set up shop more. Yeah, that was loose. So now we're going to just, like, ghost quarter. Then, like, make ghost quarter this, probably, too. Accumulated knowledge. Really? Getting in here with the Snapcaster. Got 40 more points to go, buddy. I kind of want to hit this land right now. So they can't shuffle. No, that's dumb. That's dumb. We're just going to hit the lands afterwards. I'm fairly certain we can just set up shop and just, like, keep building this big old brick house. Because I don't even want to. Like, I kind of just want to go like this. I don't really want to hit this because I want to wasteland this thing. So maybe I'll just hold. Because I want to hit the white sources, but I want to save this to hit wasteland. So yeah, let's just untap. We will dredge. Get back. Port, wasteland, maze of Ith. Red green. Not sure that it's useful and it's incomplete, but I have a file that might be useful to provide insight. Sure. I always like information. So I'm gonna just waste this right now. I haven't seen the rug land list. I don't play enough lands to really know. But so this is the plains. We're going to draw a step, hit it. Or we can just tap it. I think I want to go like this, though. Oh, they don't have another. Do you not have a white source, bud? We have a Jace, okay. So we just about have the green light here. It's hard to play the mana. The land's kind of wise. It's tough because. I saw Jody Keith stream that deck, I think. Oh, my pizza should be... Whoa, that was almost bad. Okay, my pizza's almost done. All right, let's scoop it up. I think it was Tommy's. Okay. All right, so... What do we want against this deck again? Do we want just all these? Like, these 13 cards seem like a lot. But they do seem kind of good. Alright, so let's get rid of these. These come out for sure. These come out for sure. Tabernacle comes out. May not need Ancient Tomb. I feel like I want Ancient Tomb if I'm cutting some lands, right? Thespian Sage, Riftstone Port, Riftstone Portals, maybe. Bojuka Bog. You don't need a Slam Sphere here on one of this matchup. What's CR? Crop rotation. And then, like, one, cut one more random card. And you cut one random card. Manabond. There we go. Why don't we cut Manabond? Because we have so many other good permanents. Okay. I'm going to submit this, and then I'm going to go get my pizza. We're going to keep this. Exploration. We could just slam the sphere on one. Which I don't hate. I kind of just want to slam the sphere on one. I think we're going to go for it. Cast this. Yes. Yeah. You just shouldn't do that. Let's just not show them we have a wasteland yet. Yeah, I don't really care if they counter this. You would also get forest here. Oh, because of back to basics. Yep. Yep, that was, you're right. You're right, sir. Portent. All right. So 2-1-2. I think that's the plan. But you're going to exploration into where. Oh, that would have been better. Yeah, I messed that up. So let's play this. Play our diamond. Ditch this tranquil thicket. Yeah, that would have been much better. Yeah, we're playing some lands. Having fun. I'm not doing very well. I'm only 1-3 in the league, but having a good time. I'll just skip their turn. Or... All right, let's go Maze, Misty, Tranquil. Oh, shoot. I shouldn't attack like that. Okay, well, this is okay. We can go get our forest. They're going to force this. All right, I like it. No, that makes sense. No, Schultz, that's right. That's just a clear sequencing thing that I don't know. Oh, they're going to surgical my loam? What a jerk. All right, this game's going to get harder. And it's like a little sequencing thing, too. It doesn't take a lot of effort to fix. Look at that Phyrexian mana stuff. Take a draw step. Play a land. I should hold that for Tireless Tracker. That was also loose. Yep, should hold that for Tracker. Okay, I guess we're gonna play that one. And then just port them. Probably port them off blue. You beat me to it. Yeah. I knew it right as I did it, I was like, God damn it. Tireless Tracker. Okay. So crop rotation is going to get us kind of closer. I guess crop rotation could just become another Rishadan Port. Like my opponent's going to draw out of that eventually. Accumulated knowledge, okay. We can't really actually set up a ghost quarter lock. All right, that's a pretty good draw. Tap target lands. Tap target lands. Yep, see you in a minute. One, two, three. All right, we're going to go like this. Oh, our tracker costs more. We're going to port twice, do one on upkeep, one in draw. Oh, so they can't float mana? Okay, that makes sense. That's something I'm not very good at, is playing around surgical extraction. That's like the millionth time that I've gotten surgical. It's So now, do I crop rotation? I kind of want to crop rotate. Yeah. I kind of just want to crop rotate here because it gets me a clue and lets me... it gets me a clue and it lets me port them. If he plows this, I'm just going to get port. If he doesn't plow this, I think I'm going to get a fetch land. And just like triple port them every turn. Are they surgicaling me or dismembering this? What are they doing? Why do they just take life? They're forcing pitching back to basics. Okay. That's scary. That means they're going to play back to basics this turn, like, for sure. Because, like, you don't pitch a back to basics. I don't think you pitch. I mean, I guess I have two Moxes. But I don't think you pitch back to basics. Unless you have another one here. Yeah, at least we sniff that out. All right, we got a plan, chat. It's called Beats by Tracker. Oh, no, this costs... Because this costs 4 mana, so we can't do it? No! We need a land. Oh, I should have... No, I shouldn't have ported them. I don't think we're on the port plan. We're on the fine. Get this second Tireless Tracker into play. And just beat. Okay. That thing's better than mine. All right. That's not a bad... It's not a great land. So we're going to do this again because we can play another land. Tilt. This doesn't feel good. All right, there's Jay. He's probably going to bounce my Tireless Tracker because I can't replay it. Yeah. Yep. I could have mazed that, but Chalice, right on time. All right, we're going to scoop this one up. I don't think there's any point playing this one anymore. So let's try to play around. Let's try to play around Surgical this game. Let's try to think about that. Goals. I'm going to get a piece of pizza also. Yeah, let's try that. All right, I just muted myself while I was eating. I'm sure y'all will appreciate that. Yeah, clues. So now we play our Duder. Play this guy. Play two of these. And then play the sphere. He's got a force. So he's thinking about it. So let's just play this thing and then pass. Next turn, I'll just jam Thespian stage and then probably just not do anything in the rotation. So I can just play the Tireless Tracker now. And then crop rotate for something next turn. I'm just going to run this thing out here. And now, if they don't counter this, which they might counter this. Yeah, that's what they're going to. Tilt. Nope. Okay, nice. So, next turn, we'll go crop rotation, get rid of something, get a sphere, get a tracker clue, or get a tomb, get a tracker clue, crack the clue, and then crack for four. Get them beats on. Get rid of the portal. Yeah, that's what I think. We're going to, tap it for mana, tap this, green, sack this, get our ancient tomb, get a clue. Wow, they are getting knowledge. Well, now we can do it the other way. So let's just go like this. Then we're definitely going to get a basic with this one. Oh, wow. They pitched a Jace. Oh. Let's get a forest. And we're going to use the mana floating. No, hang on. Not going to be stupid. We're going to go like this, play the sphere, and then crack in. You got another way to deal with this, man? Okay, nice. I feel like we played that well. I'm proud of how I sequenced there. I'm hyped up. I'm happy. That was awesome. Okay, so they accumulated knowledge again. So do we get greedy? Or do we just play Chalice on one? I think we just get greedy. Get our beads. Oh, we can't Chalice on one with a sphere anyways. Derp. All right, we got the grip here. Excuse me. All right. Damn it. Should have played the Chalice. Portent. I think we're pretty dead. But if I would have played the Chalice last turn, we'd be much better off. I was like aggressive, but it was stupid to be aggressive because even if I hit a land, it wouldn't do anything because the Chalice costs 3, not 2. So that was just a dumbass thing for me to do. I guess now we just don't make the second mistake again. We just Chalice for one while we have the chance. Pass the turn. We'll be right back. All right, let's play some Death Shadow. I couldn't have gripped. I couldn't tap the mana, right? And even if I could grip, I'm looking at a Monastery Mentor, which isn't good for the home team. Let's pull this up here. Stop the recording.